song.
Join the Olympics.
Track and field.
Yeah, yeah. What's your track and field? Yeah, go into the javelin. What would you be? Cross country. Something sort of meditative. I don't want to do like something totally goofy like the triple jump where you just kind of look dumb no matter what. And this song is called Half Past April.
Thank you.
getting hotter, don't it?
I'd say.
You're so good for your pants.
Let's all go for a swim.
Yeah, you guys got a pool?
You got
a rocket.
What's that?
I saw it was you that said something. Say it again. No, it was you. You turned around. What did you say? Yeah, you went, fuck it. Or rock it. Or fuck it. Or something. No? I thought you said something about the pool. Like, my house. I was like, I'm not joking. Is off of our most recent album. A song called Thought I Was. Next song is on. selection. Many of you, you all probably don't know this, but Caitlin's folks, her family hails from Poile, Vivier. That one. That's where her family's from. So it's pretty cool, I guess. In fact, we like it so much we'd like to come back and visit if anyone knows of any rooms available, like in the first week, say, of June. No, I'm not kidding. Say something to me or Caitlin instead. We're kind of around that week, and it's not that far for us, so we'll come up and pay if someone's got a room for rent. Like one person maybe, yeah. Or two, one. Remember the dress. Oh, he's got it, yeah? But you have to wait something to say.
This song.
You know, like, what do you do if you want to come stay? Everyone's like, well, are you going to student piece? And I'm like, well, what if you don't want to go to student? So anyway, this song is called I Love You Too.
Oh,
je t'aime aussi.
Again.
Je t'aime aussi. That one in 1977, so it's kind of had to compete with the Sex Pistols.
Ramones.
Yeah. That's our roadie. He's drunk again.
Give me another beer.
What's that? I can't get enough of the bass.
He needs to get back to Texas.
Back to Texas with you, Dave DuBois. Thank you. song we like to call The Contents of George W. Bush's Pockets at the Time of His Assassination.